Dear viewers, greetings. In this video, we are going to see about the two theories of chromatography. Theories of chromatography. Chromatography is a separation method that defines the differences in partitioning behavior between a mobile phase and a stationary phase to separate the components in a mixer. Components of a mixer may be interacting with the stationary phase based on charge, relative solubility, and absorption. There are two theories of chromatography. They are plate theory of chromatography and rate theory of chromatography. The first theory of chromatography is a rate theory of chromatography. The rate theory of chromatography is important for chromatographic analysis, and the theories helps to understand how the analytes move in the stationary phase as the mobile phase flows through it. The rate theory of chromatography defines the activity in a chromatographic column. It shows that when solutes eludes out from the column, it impacts the band shape and is affected by the elution rate. The rate theory of chromatography provides information about the shape and breadth of the elution bands as the mobile phase migrates and flows through a column, and it helps to understand the process of peak dispersion and factors impacting the band bonding. The rate theory of chromatography gives a realistic explanation of the process occurring in a chromatographic column. It considers and measures the time taken by the solute to equilibrate between the stationary phase and mobile phase, and the rate theory of chromatography considers the rate of elution on the resulting band shape or the chromatographic peak. Rate theory can be used to predict effects on column performances like phase properties, phase thickness, solute diffusivities, support size, support porosity, partition coefficients, phase velocity, and flow rates. Next, Van Diemter equation. And the rate theory of chromatography is expressed mathematically by Van Diemter equation. The relationship between a column's efficiency and the mechanism behind the band broadening is described by the Van Diemter equation. And mathematically, the rate theory of chromatography is represented by HETP equal to A plus B by U plus in the bracket CS plus CM into U. The full form of HETP is height equivalent to a theoretical plate, and this HETP is the measure of zone broadening. And the explanation of the formula includes A is ED diffusion parameter, B represents diffusion coefficient of eluting particles in the longitudinal direction, and C represents the resistance to mass transfer coefficient of the analyte between the stationary and mobile phase, and U represents speed. The CM represents dispersive convection in the mobile phase, and CS represents the sorption and desorption of the solute from the stationary phase. The second theory is plate theory of chromatography. The plate theory of chromatography was first developed by Archer John Porter Martin and Richard Lawrence Millington Synge in the year 1941. The plate theory of chromatography stated that each plate should be broken into a specific length, and the solute spends a limited amount of time in each plate. The size of the cell is then equilibrated between the two phases. The smaller the plate, the faster the equilibrium, and the more plate in the column. Unlike the rate theory of chromatography, the plate theory of chromatography gives a hypothetical picture of the separation of the analytes in a chromatographic column. These plates provide separation equilibrium of the sample between the mobile phase and stationary phase. The plate theory of chromatography is related to column efficiency. As the mobile phase passes through the stationary phase in a column, the analytes in the mobile phase is distributed between the two phases and establishing an equilibrium. Once the equilibrium is obtained, the solute from the mobile phase is carried from one plate to another and continues till it is eluted out of the column. The nature and solute type determines the retention time and peak width. The plate theory describes the chromatography system, the mobile and stationary phases, as being in equilibrium. The partition coefficient, or K, is based on this equilibrium and is defined by the following equation: K equal to concentration of the solute in stationary phase divided by concentration of solute in mobile phase. K is assumed to be an independent of concentration and can change if experimental conditions are changed. For example, temperature is increased or decreased. As K increases, it takes longer for solutes to separate. For a column of fixed length and flow, the retention time and retention volume can be measured and used to calculate the K value. Dear viewers, that's all about the theories of chromatography. Thank you for your support. Thank you.